face more shots than Ed Belfour, and he has been tremendous as well.
The opening faceoff brought to you by Molson, a part of the National Hockey League tradition since 1957. Molson is Canadian beer. The Hawks in the red uniforms defending the goal to the left, and they're in control of the puck after Pittsburgh had dumped it in. Out through the center ice area, Brent Sutter tips it over the Pittsburgh line, and that's cleared back by Kevin Stevens. Now the Mew moves up to left side, got bumped by Dirk Graham, the Blackhawks captain, and here's Chelios, checked from behind by Stevens. Murphy took a hit from Brent Sutter, but he got the puck to Stevens. A shot just wide of Belfour. Covering the left point is Roberts, in deep to Stevens. Steve Smith steps in front of him, and the Blackhawks fail to clear the zone. Murphy with a shot, tipped and wide of the net. Comes to the left side, Roberts held it in. Kevin Stevens trying to tip it around Chris Chelios. Now comes back along the boards, held in here by Tocchet. The Mew pushed to the boards, cross-checked by Steve Smith. Some scuffling going on. Smith is yet to release Mario Lemieux. Lemieux just now recovers his stick. The puck is dumped down the ice by the Blackhawks. First man to touch it is Murphy. And that'll be an icing call against Chicago. 1:09 into the opening period.
Well, Mike Keenan is making his third trip to the finals. He had two when he was the head coach of the Philadelphia Flyers. He is still looking for his first Stanley Cup win, and he's going up against a man who is making his 9th appearance in the finals, and Scotty Bowman is riding a consecutive streak of 5 Stanley Cup wins. He lost his first 3 when he coached the St. Louis Blues, but when he was the head coach of the Montreal Canadiens, 5 in a row.
Now Scotty Bowman has sent out a forward line that has Ron Francis at center ice, Sean McEachran on right wing, and Bob Airey on the left side. Airey was injured in the series with the New York Rangers. Airey, number 12, moves in after a loose puck. Jeremy Roenick's line is out for Chicago, and here's Roenick. Roenick dumps it in from center. First chance to play the puck for Barrasso, and it's up off the boards. Cam Russell chasing it, but here's McEachran with great speed. Diving play by Marchbutt. Then McEachran gets a chance, and Belfour able to cover the puck and hold it.
Well, the Pittsburgh Penguins showing us what kind of speed they have. That's why I think the Blackhawks' positional play will be as important as anything in this series. Sean McEachran, tremendous burst of speed through the neutral zone after Bob Airey had squeezed Roenick off the play going the other end. McEachran did a good job. As Brian Marchman dove for the puck, he actually got a piece of it. And instead of just dumping it out in front blindly, McEachran tried to jam it in on the side. Ron Francis poking for the rebound.
And here at the game tonight, the celebrity captain of the Chicago Blackhawks, Jim Belushi. All part of the 75th anniversary of the NHL. He hasn't missed very many games, has he? He is the Blackhawks. Answer to Jack Nicholson and the Lakers. Mario Lemieux back out for Pittsburgh. This time he has Phil Bourque on the left side and Jaromir Jagr on the right. Jale Samuelson and Jim Pack, the defense combination. Back of that Chicago goal, the puck tipped by Rob Brown. They get it to the left side and Noonan comes to center ice. Ryan Noonan dumps it in. Again, Chelios and Smith are the defense combination for the Blackhawks with Lemieux out there.
They can expect so much ice time with Lemieux out there, or even when Jagr is out there. I mean, Chelios and Smith should log about 30 minutes of ice time in these games.
It's Mike Hudson who stepped into Jagr. Now Jagr brings the puck across the line. Taken out is Bourque on a pinch, and there will be a penalty against the Chicago Blackhawks. Interference on Phil Bourque, and Pittsburgh will put the power play to work early in game 1 of the Cup Final.
Well, Mike Hudson is off for interference, so something the Blackhawks have to pay attention to, and that is the penalty situation is upon them. Now, Mike Hudson had come back, and he'd done a little button hook, and he actually turned and faced Phil Bourque, but you can't take a guy out that doesn't have the puck, so pretty good call by Andy Van Helleman, and the Penguins get to put their power play on the ice, a power play that's been pretty effective in the playoffs.
I'll say, compared to what they did in the regular season, they're up 3 percentage points during the playoffs. That long shot by Murphy got through, and Chelios took it from Ed Belfour and dumps it down the ice right to Tom Barrasso. Barrasso goes to the right side to Murphy, now to Stevens, up the middle, has Tocchet with him on the left, 2 men back, the pass is to Tocchet, backhands it toward the corner, here's Lemieux. Put it to the side of the net for Stevens, now to Lemieux, back to the point, Francis had a bounce off his skate. Recovered in time to move it to Larry Murphy, up ahead to Stevens. Stevens brings the power play to the line. His shot was deflected by Chelios. as Chelios found a man open here on the right wing boards, and Steve Larmer has played it out through center and back into the Pittsburgh zone. This is Murphy going back. Larmer comes into forecheck, clutching Murphy from back of the net. Murphy up the right side. That's Yager with it. Three Blackhawks. Yager got through and shot blocked. The rebound hit the outside of the net. The Chicago Blackhawks killing a penalty.